Hello everyone, welcome to the first educational video of this channel. The subject of this video is fluid art, an abstract style. I want to start with this concept at the beginning. Fluid art was founded by artists such as Jackson Pollock with drip painting in 1950, and after 2000 it found a share of the pie in the rising understanding of abstract art. After the 2010s, it continued its artistic style with techniques such as dirty pour. With the development of creative programs, it is now possible to produce such abstract works in digital form. So what is fluid art? It is an art form in which abstract and organic patterns are created by moving paints fluidly. The textures formed by the random interaction of colors are like a balance between uncontrolled and controlled intervention, a combination of aesthetics and chaos. You can use many programs for such works. I will tell you how to do it through Photoshop. I will indicate the places to pay attention to and the important points. You don't need a drawing tablet or external equipment at the beginning, and even in professional works with the techniques I will explain, the keyboard and mouse will do the job quite well. So let's start. You can set your canvas to any size you want. For this video, I will set the canvas to 1920 by 1080 pixel resolution. At the beginning of a new work, you can work on a ready-made picture from outside for learning and practice. It can be any picture you like the colors and decor, even your dog. You can also set the work you import as a smart object, so you can adjust the changes you make to the picture specifically for the picture. We don't need this now, so I'm randomizing the picture. The tool we will use the most in fluid art works is the Liquify feature under the Filter tab. This feature allows us to mix and merge the pixels of our picture. There are three settings we need to set at the beginning here: size, density, pressure. From here, you can adjust the size, pressure, and density of the area we affect. You can see the difference in the values here. I set the optimal values in my opinion. You can start liquefying as your picture allows, depending on your imagination, although it varies according to the work you want to do. You can do it like me if you want to make the work look rich and abundant. Right here, something catches my eye that you should also pay attention to: gaps. If we don't fix these gaps at this stage, we may experience minor problems in the future. We go back to the Liquify tool, but since we repositioned the image, these gaps remain outside the canvas. We will get rid of this situation with the tool that deletes pixels that remain outside the canvas in the Crop tool. Enter and enter. Let's continue. Don't forget to look at the dark side of your work. You can quickly adjust with Control and I. You can quickly adjust the contrast and brightness of your image in the panel that opens with Control and M. We can quickly play with colors with Control and U. I think I will choose the dark side. Thank you. we have a simple solution that will eliminate the gaps you see here, enlarging the work a little bit so that it extends outside the canvas. As you can see, there is pixelation. This is a problem we will always encounter. Fortunately, Photoshop comes to your aid here. Again, we will use the oil painting effect in the filter tab. It is up to you to use the lighting effect here, but I don't prefer it. In this panel, we can adjust the parameters such as how much the effect will be applied, its intensity. Another small problem. Slide left, and done. There are ready-made effects that you can apply to your work, but I prefer another panel. Here, I need to mention other things you should pay attention to. Due to the nature of fluid art, the theme of the work should evoke the impression of fluidity. It should create a movement, and movement should be provided in various directions in a flow. A certain order of movement should be created, and this order should be preserved throughout the work. This will create a strong perception and theme. The work should not be overly complex and not tire the eye, and should not undermine the emotion it wants to present. It should not be too simple and lose its visual depth and weight. The harmony of colors with each other, or perhaps their incompatibility with the purpose of the work, should also be determined with certain rules and color scale. In general, the attention grabbing of bright colors and the solid and strong stance of matte colors stand out. When you use this together, you can create a perception of layering in the work. Works are as strong as the colors that tell their own story. Therefore, color selections, brightness, and matte adjustments should be adjusted in a certain scale and order. Contrasts and differences can be emphasized through colors, using contrasting or more prominent colors than other colors to determine the focal points of the works are the primary impression determinants. The whites and blacks of the work should not be so sharp that they will tire the eye, but the brightness and contrast levels should be kept optimum and stable. In this way, the transitions and the connected visual integrity will be achieved by getting rid of artificiality. The details should be clear, and the traces left by pixelation or techniques that create style should be kept to a minimum. It is important to remove paint traces in works where oil painting effect is applied. Particle effects should not be exaggerated too much. When used to increase detail in works, file sizes increase. Since the aim is to increase both depth and quality, this technique should not be overdone in the work. We can briefly list the main points to be considered as follows. Of course, every talent is a virtue that is perfected with practice. This is your canvas. Give it the shape you want. Give it the color you want. Give it the meaning you want. What makes art art is that it touches someone somewhere. When your art touches someone else, it means that the artist, you, also touches that person. Spend time on your work, and it will give you back your time. Thus, we have come to the end of our first educational video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel for more. Like the video. You can also open the bell to be informed about new videos. You can also state your opinions on the subject in the comments section. Goodbye.